The following is a paid program.
Done everything we promised, but we have fulfilled 90% of our manifesto promises of delivery. In 2010 and 2011, we worked hard to revitalize our country after the economic decline under the previous government. We then succeeded in achieving growth in 2012, 2013, 2014, and 2015. Even with the fall in the price of oil, we ensured we kept our economy on track by ensuring a continuing flow of investment from global companies like Shell, BP, and Mitsubishi. Not only investment in our country, but more jobs too. We have created more than 57,000 new jobs in Trinidad and Tobago. In our second term, we'll continue to create more jobs for the people of Trinidad and Tobago.
That is the leadership she provides. That is why she can't tell none of them nothing. And all of them is alligator from the same murky lagoon.
Our unemployment rate is down to the lowest at 3%. This means that about 94% of our population labor force is gainfully employed.
Morning, Mr. Warner.
It is the $10 million question at the center of FIFA's global bribery scandal. The $10 million, where did it go? Cash promised by South Africa. And sent to this man, former FIFA Vice President Jack Warner.
Can you tell us where the $10 million went, Jack? Mr. Warner, where did the $10 million go to? Can you tell us one project, Mr. Warner? Can you tell us about one project that you spent the money on?
Jack Warner doesn't want to talk about the missing millions.
We have delivered goods and services. We have implemented policies which have drastically improved the lives and lifestyles of all our citizens. And that is why we have done infrastructure, healthcare development, schools, roads, bridges, drains. And when we say we are giving laptops to children, did we pick out UNC? Top partnership we gave across the board to all the children. When you leave here, you will see the Kuva, the children's hospital, off the ground, ready to open, ready to commission, ready to go.
I want to tell you something. I'm from Miss Roll in Tobago. Miss Roll very close to Lekoto. The last time I was put out of anywhere for anything, the person who put me out regretted it.
I will stand and fight with everyone and anyone. I have no fear of them. None. None whatsoever. The only thing I fear is my God. The only thing I fear is my God and yours. But as long as we put God in front and walk behind, we have nothing to fear. Nothing to fear.
Tonight. Tonight I told you I want to speak to you about morality in public affairs. Morality in public affairs means when you have put yourself up to conduct public business, you have to subscribe to principles of morality and ethics, even if they are not written in law.
And the time is about 8 minutes after the hour of 6 o'clock. A pleasant good evening to each and everyone, to all and sundry. Welcome to the election platform with yours truly, the Gladiator. It was last Friday, citizens of the Republic, I close off the show with breaking news that allegations have surfaced with regards to Dr. Keith Rowley. And these allegations are that Dr. Keith Rowley does not only have one bastard child, but has two other bastard child. In all, the allegation I closed up last week election platform with was that it is alleged that Dr. Keith Rowley has 5 children. Now, citizens of the Republic, before I enter into this editorial this evening, let me invite all and sundry to go straight to my Facebook page, and you can read my today's article entitled "Teacher Rowley Had Sex with a Minor but Wants to Be Our Next Prime Minister." I invite the citizens to go to my Facebook page, and you'll also see a picture of Dr. Rowley when he was at a younger age, when he was at age 32. That's to show the kind of investigation and the type of research I'm doing. It is on this note I am humbly appealing to first the political leader of the People's National Movement Party to allow God, Almighty God, to enter into the domain of his conscience. I call on Dr. Keith Rowley not to allow himself to be further embarrassed, not to allow his family, his children, his loving wife to be embarrassed and continue to be embarrassed as the days increase into the weeks and as we approach September the 7th. The allegations that are coming out periodically is going to hurt a lot of people. It's going to hurt the membership of the PNM party. And the people who are to be blamed would be the leadership of the PNM party. Whatsoever I, the Gladiator, discuss from henceforth, you would have caused it Dr. Keith Rowley. This I choose not to discuss for fame and glory, but this I have no other choice to discuss but to raise as a matter of public concern. As the days move along, some shocking revelation is going to hit the public, and they are not false. It will not be the mother of all lies, but would be the mother of all truths. I am appealing to Dr. Keith Rowley. You know not of what you are going to confront when the debate comes up. You know not of what is going to take place as the days into weeks and into the month comes along. Fact number one. You, Dr. Keith Rowley, which could never be denied, you was a teacher in Tobago. Fact number two, according to the laws, and what I say, citizens of the Republic, have no fear for Gladiator, because what I'm about to say is based on facts. And as the days come along, what I would say in the future shall be based on facts, based on proper and thorough research. And the picture that I'll be exposing on my Facebook page shall be based on facts. And I'm humbly warning you, Dr. Rowley, all of these things could be avoided. All of these things could come to a stop. It can come to a halt. Don't put your ego in front of the interests of the people of this country. Put this country first and not yourself. Do not embarrass the PNM party, because what is going to come in the coming days against you is going to be very, very devastating. Magan Crafton, and I want the citizens of the Republic to listen to the names of who I'm going to speak of. Magan Crafton, a teacher, could never put herself up for public office. That teacher, Magan Crafton, had sex with a 17-year-old school student, and she cannot put herself up for public office, even to aspire to be prime minister. Anne Scuds, another school teacher, she cannot put herself up for public office, and she cannot put herself up to aspire to be the next prime minister of a country. Another school teacher, she had sex with a 17-year-old student. Martina De La Rocio, another school teacher. She cannot put herself up and aspire to be prime minister, because as a school teacher, she had sex with a student. And the age of that student was 15 years old. Let me continue. Carla Dickey, another school teacher. She cannot put herself up and aspire to be prime minister because as a school teacher, she had sex with a student. Maria Anton, another school teacher. She's not allowed and she cannot put herself up. Yes, Dr. Rowdy, that school teacher cannot put herself up to aspire to be prime minister because she had sex with a 16-year-old school student. Let me leave it like that. Nikki Chowitz, another school teacher, she cannot put herself up and aspire to be prime minister because as a school teacher, she had sex with a student, a 16-year-old student. Jennifer Virgil, another school teacher, cannot put herself up for public office and aspire to be the leader of a country. Because that person, Jennifer Virgil, had sex with a student. Alicia Gray cannot put herself up and aspire to be the leader of a country because she had sex with a student. And the point I'm making, citizens of the Republic, the point I'm making is that when you breach the trust of your students, you are not fit to enter into any election race. You are not fit to hold any public office. And I could have read and read on and read on a list of school teachers . A document came, citizens of the Republic, like how Dr. Rowley said, he received emails in his mailbox. Yes, you, Dr. Rowley, you said you received emails in your mailbox in 2012. Well, I, the gladiator, receive a document in my mailbox. And it speaks about the nasty conduct, the treacherous conduct of a nasty, dirty male teacher. Whosoever sent that document in my mailbox, I do not know what they want to expose to the gladiator, but it has some shocking revelation of that nasty, dirty, stinking male teacher. And I warn you that y'all are taping. Faris Alwari, tape. Stuart Young, tape. Bola Rastaman, you Rowley, get all your attorneys at law to tape. Because what I am going to put on here is going to be shocking. It is alleged this male teacher of African descent started off kissing a school girl. Yes, a school girl. And as the relationship built up, more kiss and longer kissing, what we will call tonguing up, took place with the African school teacher and the school girl. On one occasion, this African school teacher engaged in a very long kiss, and during the kissing up, his hands passed all the way down and touched the vagina of a school girl. That same teacher, that nasty, dirty, stinking teacher, allowed the girl to sit on his lap. Kissing the girl and started to touch the school girl vagina. Now, people, hold it there. Don't start a cuss up gladiator. I'm saying, just like Dr. Rowley, he got emails from in his mailbox. I got this document in my mailbox. So we are equal. Then on a weekend, the same teacher started to touch up the breasts and telling the school girl, your breasts will get bigger very soon. And from touching the breasts, he went on to touch the vagina of the school girl. Yes, I am speaking about a school teacher. If you are cleaning your ears, gladiator is speaking about a school teacher. Let me expose the information here. On another occasion, as the relationship developed, this school teacher, this nasty, dirty, stinking school teacher, touch up the school girl vagina, and then showed her how to engage in oral sex. and call upon the schoolgirl to engage and perform oral sex on him, the teacher. Continue. The same school teacher inserted his fingers in the school girl vagina and kissed the girl. That same school girl was told by the teacher that he was preparing her for the real thing when he repeatedly inserted his finger into the girl's vagina. Citizens of the Republic, this is where the secret comes in now. The teacher told the schoolgirl not to tell anyone of what taking place between himself and the schoolgirl. A secret relationship developed with the school teacher and the school girl.
I have been in public life since 1980 on a PLN platform. I have been in Parliament since January 1987. I've fallen in love with a lot of girls.
I knew since I used to go to school, and to tell you the truth, I always used to like him since I went to school. But that is just, it used to be a secret something.
If you come forward to the political arena, come with clean hands. And once you are in the political arena, you are available to be questioned by every citizen of Trinidad and Tobago because you are managing their affairs.
Let me continue to expose the background of a school teacher. Let me continue. So this school teacher interfered with the girl, played up with the school girl vagina, and told the girl that he was preparing her for the real thing. According to the document I have before me, he told the girl not to tell anyone because he could get into serious trouble. It was one weekend when the same school teacher, a former school teacher, as a matter of fact, let me say a former school teacher, that former school teacher touch and put his finger again into the school girl's vagina and ask her if she wanted the real thing. But because of love and that young girl falling in love with the school teacher, she said yes. The school teacher had a condom and asked the school girl to help him put on the condom on his penis. And according to the school girl, the teacher hands was sweating. Water running down the teacher's hand. The school girl said she was on her back with her knees up. And the school girl said the teacher took his penis and put it into her vagina. And the school teacher, he push, come out, push, until, you all know what happened next. I don't want to tell you what happened. The school teacher took the condom and threw water into the condom. And the schoolgirl asked the teacher, why put water into the condom? The teacher said he needed to see that the condom was not leaking. At another occasion, it was repeated. And the same school teacher, the same nasty, dirty, stinking teacher, again carried on the same nasty, dirty episode. That teacher pushed his finger, you know where, people, and told the school girl it was to massage and widen for deeper penetration. At another occasion, and people, you know what happened? It is so much in this document that I have here. Let me hold back the remainder of this information, because the information is so graphic, people, so graphic, that reading this document is a typical example of what I read out early on in my editorial of school teachers who are not allowed and cannot put themselves up as candidates or aspire to hold public office. Let me open up the lines and the question that I put to you, the listening public outside there. I've read out some names of some school teachers who violated. The trust they had with themselves and the students. And the question I pose to you, citizens of the public, do you think that the names that I read out to you of teachers who have been involved in breach of trust and having sexual intercourse with their students, all from the age of 17 years going way down, do you feel that they should aspire to be president, prime minister, leaders of any group, or president of the Senate, speaker of the House? The lines are open. 222-8255. After what I've explained to you, citizens of the Republic, and I could have go on and on with a list of more teachers, do you think that they should aspire to be leaders of a particular country or of their respective country? After I explain, do you think that these school teachers and the names who I have mentioned, well, the name of this male teacher, I have not mentioned the name of this male teacher at all. Now is not the time for me to mention the name of this male teacher. But do you think that they should aspire to lead a country? Good evening, caller.
Gladiator, good evening, sir.
Good evening to you.
I think definitely not. They shouldn't be aspired to be Gladiator.
Yes, I'm hearing you.
Yeah, I think they shouldn't be aspired to be any kind of anything at all in this country besides in the prison system.
Thank you. And it's a simple question I'm asking you. Be they from the United States, be they from the Caribbean, be they from South America, from the UK, from Russia, from all parts of the globe, should these teachers aspire to lead a country after they have been found committing these acts? Good evening, caller.
Yes, good evening, Gladiator. Point 410.
Yes, point 410.
Gladiator, I think not, right? So things like that should not aspire to anything at all. Just to live a simple life and ask God for forgiveness. Now, some of the names that you called, I think I have done research and I've read on news, saw on news and read on the papers about some of those cases and those people, especially those females who were imprisoned for committing such acts, right? And if these allegations, and I know you just bring forward facts, if these allegations are really could prove themselves, I want him to challenge you again and say carry the evidence by the police, and in that way the police will be able to ask him some questions about his conduct in Tobago at the point in time, right? And I know you have not released half of that information yet because you say you have more to let go.
Because what do you think?
We want to protect the nation from somebody like that, because we don't know what will happen with him. And according to you, if that news breaks in foreign or in some big forceful country, what will be the outlook of Trinidad and Tobago, knowing that we had known that before, and we still put this man for prime minister with that type of character that he possessed. So, Gladiator, I will listen to you very attentively now, and I'll call in probably later if I get the chance. So,
thank you very much.